by tropics. We're about 3 kilometers from the coast on the west coast of India in the state of Karnataka. And we are here at the farm of my friend Vasu.
Hello, I am Vasu Deva. This is my ancestral property. My father inherited from his mother, and mother inherited from her father. And this farm has been here for maybe more than 500 years. But we have incorporated small extra things. Like farm would be with the paddy and plantations like this. Most of the cases, it will be either coconut or arecanut alone. So here we mixed with the banana, some fodder, border crops. You can see various fruit trees and timber trees like teak and pepper growing on the coconut, pineapple. So we try to do a multi-layered farming system. So I did my master's in agriculture. So after that, or during my agricultural graduation, I came across a lot of alternate form of farming, including permaculture. So I developed some interest in permaculture, organic farming. So I thought of developing my farm based on these principles. So we did change the planting pattern here, and also did a lot of soil and water conservation.
So this was originally a rice paddy, and Vasu went and he studied permaculture and wanted to create a multi-story system. So originally they planted bananas. The bananas got plenty of sun and they yielded fruit. But then as time went on and the coconut palms and the arabia palms grew up, more shade came over the bananas. And at this point, the bananas are actually used for their leaves. They sell the leaves for plates. People cut them up and they make them into plates for events they have here. They also cut the bananas down. They use them as fodder for the cow. So there's lots of different species in this multi-story forest garden here. But the main crops, their main economic crops really, are the pepper vines that are trained up the various palm trees, the coconut palms, and then of course the arachia palm as well. There are also lots of other plants that are mixed into the system. We've got, aside from the palms and the banana, we've got guava, breadfruit, pineapple, pepper vine, jackfruit, cashew nut, custard apple, mango, moringa, starfruit, taro, tamarind, cassava, amblica, papaya, sapote, rose apple, rice, hibiscus, mulberry, chilies, a whole assortment of vegetables, gourds, and then there's a lot of different grasses that are just grown as forage crops to feed the one cow that provides the dairy products for the farm. So, a really fascinating example here from the wet, dry tropics on the west coast of India.
In home gardens and orchards in this region, there's a natural layering that is done with a mosaic of annual fields, hedgerows, tree crops, fodder fields, and forest. What Vasu and his family have done in this garden is atypical and represents a permaculture adaptation with greater diversity of species and intricate multi-storied production within the coconut understory. The diversification of crops, especially the pepper and banana leaves, have added positively to the farm's income.
As I said before, this is the wet, dry tropics, meaning they actually have a 4 to 6 month dry period here. And so they've put in a more conventional sprinkler system, but the wells here, when we think about a well, the wells are actually these wide, open, excavated tunnels that go down, and they do intercept the water table. They also act as cisterns themselves. They get about 3,000 to 4,000 millimeters of rainfall a year during the wet season. That's super wet. That's like 120 to 160 inches of rainfall per year. So all that water is percolating down here. The soils don't really hold water. That water is percolating down
the well here is tapping into the water table, and it's also an open reservoir that is getting the rainfall directly into it. This is a new well here, and then the traditional well, the older well, is right there adjacent to the bathhouse. And that's all the water they need to irrigate the main 2-acre zone 1-2 forest garden.